fees too.
All right, we'll call our final budget workshop to order before our regularly scheduled meeting. Now, as far as our agenda for this afternoon, I think pretty much we will give everybody an opportunity to say exactly what's on their minds, if you have anything to say.
Sounds like we're going to adjourn.
Sounds like that. We've heard all the presentations. We've had the manager's numbers. And in response to the manager's numbers, does any commissioners have anything to say?
I guess I would like to, Mr. Chairman, make one suggestion, and that is, why don't we get any expansion items out of the way first? If there's going to be any expansion items, before I would want to cut the budget, I'd want to know what they were, you know.
Okay.
Me.
165. I'm gonna tell you the one that I know I'm standing on, and that is the one that I proposed, and that was the 2% COLA for the employees.
I agree with that. There's one that I would like to address in the Sheriff's Department. Chief Rose came over and he told us the cuts and that he had already made in the budget. And it left him, he said, I think, Vic, if you were sitting beside me, but I think he said it would cut him down to about 6.5 cars. He said he might be able to make 7 if he did some other things. I'd like to add another car to his fleet and make it an even 8. I just don't want to get in a situation like we were a few years ago when we've got to have 20 cars at one time. So I'd like to see that done.
Anybody else?
What's that, $36,000?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
Is that what one car runs with? About 36.
Did you say
that's,
six?
That's what they originally had, 36. That buys it, outfits it, and does everything they need.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Did you say 6 or 7 cars? Yeah, he said
He said that the money that he's got would buy him about 6.5 cars, but he thought he could make it 7. So I suggested let's just add one car to it and make it an even 8.
Why don't you just make it 7 or even 7? If you add one car to it, you're making 8.
Well, I suggested that. You don't have to vote for it.
Yeah, I'm just asking.
Okay.
I'm trying to vote so I can vote for it. I know what I'm going to vote for. You don't have to tell me what I'm going to vote for. I know what I'm going to vote for.
No, I just don't want to get in a situation like we were a few years ago where they have to come to us and get 15 to 18, 20 cars at one time.
You don't have to worry about that long as I'm here no more.
So, are we voting for a half a car or a full car? That's
full car.
Full car, okay.
Make it 8.
I just want to know.
And
the question is, Gary, if it's 6.5, you're authorizing another car, which is 7.5.
No, he could make it 7 with what he's got.
Okay.
And then we add one full car.
So let me back up. And then that way we'll know exactly what the expansion list is going to exactly look like. I talked about the 2% COLA for the employees, and we can pretty much do a straw vote, and we can construct the expansion in that way. So and keeping in mind that this is just a straw vote, how many say yay to the COLA? Yeah, raise your hand.
Yeah.
Okay, is that everybody?
Look, let me, before we vote on that, the only problem I got with the COLA, and I want the employees to do well. I believe in that, but it's hard for me to vote for a COLA when the Beaufort County schools are going to cut like 36 positions. I mean, isn't it a little bit ironic that we would vote to give some people a raise, but at the same time, other folks are going to lose their jobs. And I know that's not our fault, a lot of it, but we did vote last year to maintain some jobs in that budget until the state came through with them. And that, I'm not opposed to the COLA, but I do think there's some irony involved in it when one group of folks are losing their jobs and the other group of folks are getting a pay raise.
Well, actually, the school board elected to do that, and there's going to be some positions lost, but I think from what he said was what Don Phipps said was that some of it would come by attrition, and they'd probably wind up actually losing six jobs.
Well, I realize a lot of it's going to come from attrition, but you know, if they have to send somebody home, they'd have to send them home, which is not good.
Well, you know,
and in this budget, if I'm not mistaken, Brian, we're not sending anybody home. Everybody's keeping their job. Nobody's losing their job in Beaufort County, which is a good thing. I like that. Anyway, that's all I want to say about it.
Okay. Now, as far as the 8 calls proposed by Commissioner Brand, everybody's in favor of that one, raise your right hand.
Mr. Chairman, so everybody understand the dollar amount, if you go back to his original budget, that means you would increase it $46,800. So we've got a dollar figure.
Okay.
That's what it would take. I came up with $46,800.
I think for one vehicle, all they're looking for is $36,000.
Yeah, but in his budget, it's like 6 point something. And when you do the math, and then it takes an extra $10,000. Because there's not exactly enough in there to do the 7 if you use 36. I use 36.
Oh, he was going to come up with that money from somewhere else. That's the other half.
Yeah.
That wasn't coming out of our budget.
No, that was coming out of his budget.
Charlie told me that he had found money to get it to 7 from other sources.
So is...
They got drug seizure 36. Money and stuff like that.
Is that what we're voting on?
36,000.
Okay, well, let's do the straw vote again so everybody understand. All in favor of adding that $36,000, raise your right hand. Opposed? Nothing happens. So that is a wash. Who's the power broker and he's not involved? All right, let's continue.
An expansion budget.
Mm-hmm.
I was looking here at BATS, and I wish that we could grant them something. I know that they're having troubles, and all of those 90% of those people that they're servicing need and rely on that service. So I would love to see them get something. I wouldn't put a number amount on it. I know what we gave them last year. But
what they had requested in the expansion was $30,000 for BATS.
Well, I could say half of that.
BCDC was flat. They said they were fine with what they got. But they asked for an additional $30,000 on the transportation.
And that's just the way I feel. I mean, if you're doing something, I mean, these are mainly senior people.
So you're saying
$15,000.
If it passes, it passes. If it don't, it don't.
Okay. What are your thoughts on the 15? All in favor of that?
Well, I got a question.
Okay.
You said the other night that you had some questions about BATS. What was that about?
My questions were pretty much with fees. And, you know, what they were charging people to go from point A to point B. But
well, you know, when I looked at those fees, it looked like to me that the only way you come out on those fees is to buy the monthly pass. And then you're going to do okay. But if you don't mind a monthly pass, it's kind of high.
Yeah.
I mean, be perfectly honest about it. Well, I read that chart. But so, you know, but I think the monthly fee was like $50 for the whole month. Bats, one thing you got to remember about bats is there are a lot of people in this county that go to dialysis, have to go to doctor's appointments, and they don't have a ride, and they can't find a ride. And bats is the savior for them. I know that a lot of folks, when I used to talk to Gray Hodges, he said one of his biggest places that he took people was to the dialysis center. And people can't find a ride to the dialysis center. That's kind of tough because they need the dialysis 3 times a week.
Okay.
A question. Do they carry Medicare and Medicaid patients to the doctors?
They do. And they do serve as the county's transportation piece. I mean, there's, like he talked about the other day.
Okay, well, all in favor of the 15,000 addition, raise your right hand. Okay, that's good.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes, sir.
I'd like to, the senior center, Washington Senior Center, I'd like to recommend that we give them some dollar amount since there's a large number of seniors in the county that are using that center.
And do you have a number in mind?
Probably 25,000, maybe, or maybe 20,000.
I'll support 20.
20.
Any other discussion concerning that?
Did they get anything now? I was looking for outside agencies in there.
I can't find it.
I'm right now and I can't find
it. I can't find the seniors.
What page is
it? It's over here on the last page.
That's the expansion item.
What page is the outside agencies, Brian?
165.
That's a Harbor District.
That's the expansions.
They don't get anything now.
They don't currently receive anything from the county. There's flow-through money that comes from the state that flows through the county that goes to them. But there aren't any county tax dollars, general tax dollars, going to them.
How much did he say? They're on page 112.
Well, the other comment I would make is that I'm not sure who's responsible for closing Bellhaven, but I think that was funded through Mideast. Was that the only one?
It's that same money. See, what happens is there's money from the state. It flows to the county. The money that was going to Bellhaven was flowing through the COG.
But that one closes as of June 30th.
Yeah. And the one thing about, and not trying to sway you either way, the one thing about the senior center is they're not allowed to charge for, I mean, they can charge for things like trips. But for you to use the center, they can't say to you, we're going to charge you for it. They can't do a differential. They can't even do a differential and say, okay, you're a county resident, we'll charge you this. If you're a city resident, we'll charge you this. Because they're a center and they receive state funding to provide that service, they're not allowed to charge. So
it's not a conflict if you're old enough as a commissioner to use the center.
No.
I don't think it's paying a strong thing.
Just checking for Robert's benefit.
All right. Anything further? All in favor of that? Opposed? 5-1. 5-2.
Who's it?
4-2.
Brandon Belcher.
Who would it be?
4-2.
4-2. Yeah. I keep looking at you, Hood.
I'm sure I won't be here again.
Well, can I interject something? Because I think it'll in the interest of time, like with the DSS, and I think we can get consensus on this pretty much, that their income maintenance worker, the custodian, and then the admin reclassification. I think that's something all of us can pretty much agree on, unless I'm wrong.
Didn't cost us any money, did it?
No, not really.
I'm okay with it.
So we don't need to keep that hanging.
So, Mr. Chairman, you're doing DSS maintenance person?
Mm-hmm.
That one does cost you something.
That does cost something. Yes, but it's hold on.
It's the custodian.
The custodian is completely offset.
It's the custodian, but the income maintenance worker, this is
21.
21,504.
Yeah, but I'm still good with that.
And you're saying that and the social worker too, and the other.
The custodian, the administrative assistant reclass, okay. And the custodian and the income maintenance worker.
How much is that in dollars there, Brian?
The custodian is completely offset, so there's no cost there. The DSS income case maintenance worker is $21,504, and the admin reclass was $23,48.
So that's a total of what?
In new money?
$23,852. Okay. We'll pull that one next.
That's new money.
Okay. Did we do the straw vote? No. Okay. All in favor of that?
I'm in favor of some of it. I'm in favor of that reclass. That one where it whacks, where it evens. I'm not sure I'm in the favor of the other.
Okay. So that's 5-1. And then the salary adjustment for the lady at Soil and Conservation.
I think that's something we need to do.
Well, let me do this one this way. Is anybody against that one?
No. How much money is that total?
$8,390. Yeah, she's not getting back pay. We're not doing that. It's like the song Kenny Rogers said, you better know when to hold them and know when to fold them. Say again?
Maintenance technician.
That was reclassified.
The maintenance technician, that's in the enterprise fund for the water department.
That's for Christina.
That was actually in the building.
That's not.
It was a public works position in maintenance.
Yeah, well, anyway, still you.
Yeah. Didn't cost you. Is that the one?
Income maintenance in DSS.
Yes, well, this.
Okay. Is that the one didn't cost nothing?
No. Oh, sir. The only ones that run into those kind of things when you get federal offset, state offset, that was DSS.
I thought she was some lap salaries or something.
We up to that, Frank.
Just wait. Let me see.
Harper, the clerk, the finance officer.
Was that an expansion?
Yep.
Yeah, that's a net savings of $94.
Yeah, that was a no-brainer.
No,
I vote for
savings.
That.
That's a
1 year $94, dude. I want to remind you, it's a reoccurring cost. You're not going to lay her off.
Recurring $94 savings.
Every year?
Yeah.
Now, what about the maintenance technician up for Christina, though? I'd like to propose that.
Okay. Uh-huh. Did y'all hear what Commissioner Buzzio said?
The maintenance technician for Christina.
Folks, we need to be really careful about these recurring costs. You're getting into that mindset, but that thing's going to bite you this year. It's going to bite you next year, and it's going to bite you in 2025. If you keep adding positions. I mean, I hate to sound like hood, but I'm. It's a terrible thing, isn't it? But I mean, it's true. When you're adding positions, you're putting that in there forever.
Okay.
Well, I'd like to say, you know, if anybody needs an assistant, he does. I've been around watching him, and that's a hardworking guy. And I'd like to see him get the position. I understand what Bob's saying. But when it all comes down to it, we do need maintenance in our buildings here, and he's only one person.
Okay, all in favor of that, raise your hand. Opposed? Okay.
No, I was for.
Okay, it was just Booth and Belcher, the killer bees.
How much money, bro?
That was $56,445.
What did you say, 56 what?
445. And that was one, two. What was the vote on? So you have six.
Your math's getting like mine.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes, sir.
Are you ready for another one?
Yes, sir.
I'd like to see us start phase one of a three-year plan to do the renovation of the courthouse. And that number's $107,500.
Okay. Any discussion?
I just, a question. I mean, I'm fine with it, but I just, when you say phase one, what is this?
Well, phase one includes the engineering costs. That's $7,500, I guess.
I got you.
And that $100,000, the budget is, three-year budget's $300,000.
I got you.
Or they estimated over a three-year plan, but, you know, the courthouse was built and moved into in 1969, and it just needs a lot of tender love and care. When you could walk up to the front door, it's the first impression of Beaufort County if you're here for the first time.
Sure enough, if you're going through the basement.
All right, anything further concerning that?
No.
All in favor, raise your right hand. And that was unanimous. Okay, let's see.
Mr. Chairman, I have another one.
Okay.
This one is on tourism or economic development, whatever phase you want to put it under. I'd like to see us have $15,000 in the budget, and that would be for a 50-50 match, just like we did last month or this month for Belhaven Community Chamber of Commerce, where they have a project going on and they can match whatever the county puts in. And I would say $15,000. We had $20,000 in the so-called tourism authority that we ended up using. But I think we somehow or other we need to incent local communities to either update their web so it conforms to an iPad and a smartphone, and they can use the platform that we also helped put together or funded.
Could I ask them a question?
Yeah.
I mean, I see where you're headed with this, but when you say 50-50 match, is it?
If they come to us asking for $5,000, mm-hmm. they've got to put $5,000 in.
Okay. Can they come twice and ask for the same entity? Can they come two times and ask for $5,000?
That would be up to us, I guess. I mean, we couldn't keep them from coming and asking, but I'd like to see us spread it around. I mean, that was the idea of getting started with this, is that Belhaven is the first one to do the new website to conform. And, you know, the Chocolatey, Aurora, somebody else would step to the table. And they might only ask for $3,000, you know, just like Cliff said, that he thought he could get it done cheaper, so if he only needed six, and they put in three, we would put in three.
Now, this is for tourism.
Well, I'd say tourism. I mean, if you want to call it economic development, but something that helps promote Beaufort County as a whole and them individually. And that's a 5,000 decrease over last year.
Okay. Any further discussion? All in favor of the tourism 15,000. Raise your hand. Okay, that's 5-1.
I've got another one.
Okay.
On the Cooperative Extension Service, the 4-H
van,
the two vans, we would actually fund one, and Potash Court would fund the other one. So our cost would be
$32,000. Isn't that right, Brian? $32,000 would be our part.
Yeah, we threw some recurring.
Yeah, it's $2,000. So that would be right. That'd be 32.
Instead of 60, Frankie.
Hi.
Instead of that 60 that's in here, it was two in here.
Yeah, he's
64. It'd been 64.
Potash is paying 32 too, so we got both of them.
Well, actually, let me clarify that. They would pay. The reason we showed 32 was we showed 30 for the capital to purchase a vehicle, and then we showed an additional 2,000 for maintenance and fuel.
That's for both vehicles.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. I got it.
Potash would only pay to
for the vehicle.
The vehicle.
30. Okay.
We also have another commitment, but and it was not reflected in their presentation. Tri-County Foundation is going to do some, and they're going to use that for operation.
Okay.
Okay. All right, any other discussion concerning the 4-H van?
So, do I have anything? Say what now?
Anything further?
On the van.
On the van?
Yeah.
All in favor? That one's unanimous.
I got one.
Okay.
On the monies that we allocate for the municipality recreation programs, I'd like to see that go to the same thing that they got last year on all of the municipalities.
Okay. Any discussion as far as though that
Mr. Chairman,
well, that's really not part of the expansion anyway, so that really wouldn't.
Well, it's on here.
No, that's
expansion for Bellhaven, because he hasn't got any money for Bellhaven in it. You're gonna have to add that if you do it.
Well, I want to see Mr. Chairman.
Yeah, go ahead.
I want to see Bellhaven and Pantiga added at the level that they got last year. I mean, I understand what was there during the budget workshop.
Pantiga's in there at the same level. The only one that's not in there for anything is Bellhaven.
Okay. But that's they already
everybody else is in the original budget that was submitted. What you're seeing in the expansion is Bath and Chocowinity's asking for additional funds.
And I'd like I'm sorry, did you carry?
Was the motion, Jerry, to fund them at the same level as last year?
Yes.
That's already in the budget.
Okay. But I was confused there for a minute.
Yeah, what we're doing here is
you just have to if you're doing it, Bellhaven is an expansion item on that because it's not in the budget.
Right.
Okay. How much is Bellhaven, Brian?
$10,800.
$10,800.
Isn't that what we gave them last year?
That is what you gave them last year.
Yep. But didn't
so,
we?
So you need to find out for sure if that's what you want to do because we had the discussion and saying because they owed us $20,000 that you were not going to give it to them. So.
Well, we actually Well, let me clarify that. There was $10,800 in this year's budget. They typically the municipalities send us a request for that money. We send it to them. They didn't, and because we had the outstanding EMS bill, we applied that to that outstanding EMS bill.
So you didn't spend it.
This year's
the current year.
Yes, sir.
But they still owe us $10,000 for 2016-2017. Well, they still owe us $10,000 for this year. The question is, do we want to take it out of 2016-2017?
That's for you to decide.
Do you? So I don't have to look back. Under the 2016-2017, you giving anything to Bellhaven?
No, sir.
No.
He was saving that to pay the outstanding balance on their debt. But apparently, if we pass this motion, we'll be putting it back in. And basically what we're saying, and I talked to Ed about, we're not going to punish children for what adults have done.
Okay.
And that's the bottom line there, that very children true. Recreation programs shouldn't be punished because adults are not acting right.
Gary, so you made that.
Yes.
I'd like to amend it, if I may, tell you what I'd like to amend that. If I could, Mr. Chairman?
Yeah, go ahead.
For Bath, Chocowinity, and Washington, I'd like to, the increase would be a total of about $8,700 and would be $1,700 to Bath. What this is one time, $2,800 to Chocowinity and $4,268 to Washington.
Plus,
it's all about $8,700 increase.
Plus the money for Bellhaven.
Well, he already put that in his motion.
That's what I'm saying. Once you put the two together, that's your new total.
Yeah,
$18,000.
What's your total, Ron?
$8,790. From Bath, that between Bath, Chocowinity, and Washington. Washington getting the most.
That would make it $18,770.
It would be with Gary's 10 would be $18,790.
Okay.
Can I get the numbers again from you? What was Bath?
Bath would be increase of $1,729. Chocowinity,
$2,800.
And that for cap of $4,268.
$4,268 for Washington.
Okay. Then Gary had the $10,000.
Yes,
that was $10,800.
That's how much?
$10,800. Wasn't it Frank or 10-8?
Yeah.
It's $19,597.
Is the total?
Yes, sir.
$19,597.
Y'all are keeping a running tab, aren't you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Now, anything for the two enterprise funds we will talk about.
Mr. Chairman, you get a vote on that?
Well, I'm going to do it.
Okay, sorry.
But I'll just say anything that we're going to have to do with the enterprise funds, we'll do later because it's not part of the mm-hmm. of this process. Yeah. All right. Now, concerning the 19597.
Why don't you break them out, Mr. Chairman, vote twice. Can you do that? Break the Belhaven out.
Okay. The Belhaven of 10,800, is that correct?
Mm-hmm.
What's the pleasure concerning the 10,800 for Belhaven? Okay, that's. And now concerning it was it Bath,
mm-hmm.
Chocolatey, and Washington, right?
Right.
And do you want those three broken out separately or all together?
Yeah.
Now concerning Bath, Chocolatey, and Washington, what say the board? Okay. That's, yeah, 4-2.
How much was that total?
And that was the?
87.90.
So we were right back at the 19,597.
That didn't make sense to get somebody for increases and then
everything. Mr. Chairman.
Okay.
I'd like to see us add $5,000 to our existing budget for the Boys and Girls Club.
Okay.
We're currently at 40,000
even, I think. Isn't that right?
Mm-hmm. And you want to, instead of the 20, you want to give five?
Bump it five.
Right, I got you.
It's at 40
now. So it'll be taking it to 45. Any discussion concerning this $5,000?
Do we ever get any information on how they spend their money?
We've never asked because basically with the Boys and Girls Club, I've always felt that you can walk in there anytime and find out anything that you. It's pretty much wanting to find out, mm-hmm. but if that's something that you want to do, certainly we can require that. That's yeah. not a great.
I mean, I'm just wondering whether they ever have come back to us and told us exactly how they spend the money.
I actually sit on their board, and I did that when I actually got appointed to that position when I was there in Washington. But I'd be glad to provide anything you need on that.
Yeah, I'd like to see a breakdown on it.
They have a local board.
Well, I served on that board, and they can give you the money to spend in this county. I mean, every dime that Beaufort County gives goes to Beaufort County, but it's also allocated by certain line items. You got different programs that so much go to this program, so much go.
And we have all their financials. They've given us everything. They've given us our audit, okay. Their financials, every bit. We'll be glad to share all that with you.
They'll haul you out if you don't spend that money wisely.
Any further discussion concerning this $5,000? All in favor? Opposed? 5-1. Okay.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, sir.
I'd like to recommend for the Ruth House, they come in and ask us, I think, for 20-something thousand, but I'd like to recommend $2,500.
So you're giving them a tithe of what they asked for?
10% of what they asked for.
Yeah.
How much
did we give them anything at all now, Jerry?
Yes.
Yes.
How much we giving them now?
What did we give them?
Turn the page.
2,500.
So you'd be doubling what they get.
They requested 25,000.
But they requested 22,500.
Yeah.
What you requested was a $20,000 increase above the $2,500 we were given.
And but this is really like a capital project where they're going to convert one of their
capital
bathrooms to a bathroom and handicap. Yeah.
Capital. Given to them as capital.
Okay. Anything further concerning the
$2,500? So could I ask a question on that?
Yes, sir.
When you said capital, is the board intending for that to be a one-time appropriation, or is the board intending that to be a recurring appropriation?
My intention was one time.
Okay.
That would let us know next year.
One-time appropriation.
Okay. Anything further concerning this item? All in favor? Okay, that one's unanimous.
Mr. Chairman, I don't know whether it would be right to go back and say the same thing on the Boys and Girls Club, because what I heard from our speaker was that they're trying to open something, so they got startup costs at Northeast Elementary. So I don't mind that being a one-time hit if that would help anybody. We've already voted on it, but that was really my thought process.
I have no issue with that, Mr. Chairman.
It's kind of after the fact, since we talked about this one being a 1 year.
And also the Chuckawinity one would be a one-time capital for the $2,800.
So basically what you're saying is your expansions for recreation are a one-time.
The one for Chuckawinity, one-time.
Unless anybody has any problems, I'd like to see the $5,000 on the Boys and Girls Club be capital.
Mm-hmm. That, you mean a one-time?
Yeah.
Doesn't give you any kind of headache, does it?
No, we just need to know how. Okay. So we'll know next year whether to plug it in or not.
Why did you want Belhaven Recreation Department to only be a?
No, Chuckawinity.
Chuckawinity.
Yeah, because that was for
Belhaven.
No, sorry. They wanted to, it had to do with their equipment or
concession stands.
Yes.
Okay.
So only Chuckawinity.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see. Well, that's what I'm looking for.
The revocation of the magistrate's office.
The renovation of the magistrate's office?
Yeah. What do we think about that?
What did we say the other night? Was that a study done or no? What did we say the other night about?
We didn't really say anything. We said there was a lot of space down there, but I think what
they said was that I don't have it booked with me. But they wanted to renovate the magistrate's office itself. I believe that's what it was.
Well, some of them cutting a door so.
They're cutting a door so they could get out of there if there was in trouble.
And I think that's all we need to do. And I maybe it's got some flack from it, but I think that's about all you really need to do at this time, is just pretty much give them an escape route, because anything else, I think you're gonna really have to really think
that
through.
Have a bomb go off or something.
Yeah, I mean, because
that item is on page 214.
Mr. Chairman, Christina's sitting here. Let's ask her how much her escape route, she thinks an escape route would cost off the top of her head.
If you have the answer to
it. I'm putting you on the spot, Christina, but it's.
but it would be considerably less than the $55,000 that's listed in the expansion item.
Yeah, and that's what I'm thinking. We can give them what they really need without incurring as much cost.
Mm-hmm. So there's already an existing wall, and we would just be cutting it out according to this little diagram.
Yeah. And putting in a door.
Mm-hmm. Putting in a door.
The question that would be is, because of the grade, do I need to go there?
Yeah.
The question would be, because of the grade of the courthouse, because it is in the basement, where we would cut the hole in the wall, we would either give them an escape into a storage room, which would basically just be a safe haven where they would then have to stay there until someone else came to assist. Or we would have to get structural engineering advice to see if there's a possible way that we could slide that over just a bit and do excavate around the perimeter of the stairs and then put in a door and do some structural changes there. So it depends if we give them an escape to a storage area as a safe haven or if we give them an escape to the outside. But because of the magistrate's office being in the basement, it's not as easy as just cutting a hole in the wall, because if you cut a hole in the wall, you're going to walk into the earth. So we'd have to do an excavation, do similar to the stairs that are located on the east side of the courthouse, where there's a retaining wall around the stairs that go down to the basement.
So this thing where it says escape route here on this picture, have you got the picture?
I do.
Is that
that's something
through brick and dirt there?
Yes, that is. And I think that's something also that when this sketch was drawn, it wasn't totally taken into account that this was a basement.
So, and I don't know, where's the bathroom at in that magistrate's office?
It's located where the magistrate sits. There's a private restroom for them just to the right. It's actually included in their area. They do not need to get up and leave their office confines to use the restroom.
Ain't no space between that wall and the bathroom? I don't know. I'm just asking.
No. So public, the public restrooms are located at the opposite end. It's just like the elevator. The restrooms are in the worst possible place in the basement. The elevators turn the worst possible direction. It makes it difficult. But the problem comes into with the grade, with it being in the basement.
Is that wall on the other side of that bathroom, is that a where? I'm not familiar with that wall there. Is that
the jail?
That's into the corridor, into the lobby area. It's into an open
public area. The backside of the bathroom?
Yeah. What does that go?
The jail.
Into the jail.
Yeah.
What I was asking is, if you cut a door on the other side of that bathroom, can he escape out that door into the jail?
No.
What?
No.
You
no.
Can't do it.
You might want to stay in there with the mattress on.
See that dotted line I see, that's an existing wall then.
Yes.
I can't envision.
Well, part of it is in the public area. The dotted line that it goes above the magistrate's, between that and the restroom, that's just open area. Unfortunately, if you were to cut a hole or a entryway in the restroom that's shown on the plan, the only thing that would do is allow the magistrate to go into the open lobby area, which if there was a person coming in to cause harm to them, that's where they would be coming from. Right. So it wouldn't do any good to get the magistrate out of harm's way.
But now with this plan, correct me if I'm wrong, the idea was to provide an access door so that if you came in after hours, based on the new security stuff, that if you came in after hours, you would go only in, you could only get into the magistrate's office from the outside. You would come in, and then if there was an issue that happened, the magistrate could go around to the back.
Through a door into the storage area.
Right, and then the big issue was not being able to, the public roaming around the basement of the courthouse at night after the doors were locked, and we'd have to have some other way for the public to get into the magistrate's office.
But that with the security system, with the security, that would take care of that, because the way that law enforcement and those who really had business after hours, they would have access in, but John Q. Public would not have access into there unless they were buzzed in. Am I correct?
Unless they were buzzed in, but once they are buzzed in by the magistrate, then they would have be able to
run
around the lobby area of the basement.
Another question.
Look here.
I don't know, maybe Mr. Williams over there more than anybody probably, but when I want to call them a prisoner, because they hadn't been to prison, if you can't, to the magistrate.
Yeah, defendants.
The defendants. Do they actually go in there right where the magistrate sits at?
No. They go in. They go into the magistrate's office, and the magistrate has a petition, and he has a door. Mm-hmm. But if somebody really wanted to get them, they can get them.
Okay.
I'll put it to you that way.
Yep.
They can get them. If they really want to get them, they can get them.
I got you. Theodore, I got you.
So what are the thoughts of the board?
Well, I think
confused about it. I don't know.
Well, I don't know how much it's going to take to cut that door in there.
Well, it's not going to be $55,000.
No, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, you know? But
could, if it was $10,000, could we take that out of the $100,000 in renovation? Could we? Is that a stretch? If it was $10,000, I mean.
It would just be adding an additional project to the amount. I mean, I can. I'll do the best I can with the funds available.
Take it out of the $100,000. I mean, I'm assuming once you get a price, you come back and we can make a decision whether we want to do it.
There's no possible way it would be $10,000 to put a door in.
Mr. Chairman, I make the motion that we take the whatever it costs to renovate the magistrate's office, the smaller renovation project, and take it out of the $107,500 for the courthouse renovation.
Can I ask for clarification on what the smaller project is? As far as what
they're saying, not doing the 55, but doing the door.
Which door? The door into a safe haven, or
the safe haven.
I'm just asking for someone else to make the decision of the door.
The safe haven.
The exterior public door is really, I think, the door that we need. Correct. Because otherwise, we've got folks roaming around the basement at night.
You're in two different places now.
Well, we're talking about
the magistrate's office and the magistrate's office alone.
Yeah.
And we're talking about cutting a door so that they can go into the supply room, which is now their safe haven.
Right. I understand what you're saying. What I'm saying is after 5 o'clock, our procedure will be, once we get all the security stuff in place, that door will lock down.
Right.
And what our proposal was with this was to put in another door that after hours the magistrate would be able to buzz that person in just to the magistrate's office. That's the only place they would have access to. They couldn't get into the basement of the courthouse. They would only have access into the where you see that door coming down the corridor.
Okay. We're not gonna do that.
Okay.
I mean, we will secure that door, but as far as doing that kind of major renovation, no.
Second.
I got a question. Mm-hmm. If you make a door that he can go on the outside from the basement to Second Street, is that what you were talking about?
No, that's the $55,000. Job.
Well, yeah, that would cost $55,000 digging through that dirt.
if you're asking to the safe haven, to the storage room, is that what you're specifying as? Then certainly much less than that. I would, if it's just to cut a door through that, I would request $3,000, and if I need more than that, I could take it out potentially, but I think that should be sufficient.
Okay.
To just cut a door into the storage area.
I'm going to go in the door hanging.
A steel door, yes.
Hmm? I'm going to go in the door hanging business.
We want it done right.
It's in the right. Plus, it's in the basement. You don't want anything falling down.
That's right. Okay. All right.
He seconded.
Okay, so we're doing the door to the safe haven. Is that correct?
This that $3,000 door. Whatever that cost out of the $107,500 that we already approved.
Okay. All in favor of that, raise your right hand.
Vote for it, but I sure don't like it. I'd hate somebody to run me in a closet.
He ain't got to go. It's up to him whether to go in there or not.
All right, I'm gonna ask the question. The schools have offered some expansion items as well. There was the security upgrades, and that was how much? What was that? That was four what?
$466,920.
And then there was the personnel. Was that?
That was about $3 something or something.
325.
When you say personnel, what are you talking about? I know you're talking about
current expenses. Capital would be the four. Would be the 466,920. Would be capital for safety.
I mean, when you say personnel,
it would be in the regular budget because they're estimating. It would only save some of the positions. They're estimating now under the current budget, the budget proposed for 2016-2017, they're going to be laying off 10 to 15 people, which is about...
What page is that on, Ron?
He's got that handout.
I just got on stuff they provided. So we'd give them back some of those positions. About 300,000 to 25 would be about... Six positions, maybe they can absorb the other things. That you'd be able to give them back, and they wouldn't have to cut the additional ones. Because in the budget he proposed to us, I think it was 23 TAs and 13 teachers they were cutting before they gave us the budget. Then what the budget recommended would be an additional 10 to 15 positions. So if we give them about 325, that saves, I don't know how many positions, six or seven maybe? About 325, roughly. About 40,000, 50,000. About six positions. So it allows them to save some positions, and hopefully they can do it some of it through attrition. But otherwise, the schools are taking a major hit. And a concern I have, Mr. Chairman, is that I think the safety and security of the students and the teachers, I think it's extremely important that we move with that, and I think it's a 5-year plan for them to provide security for the schools.
They really do need to do something at P.S. Jones or John Cotton, the one out there on Market Street Extension.
It's John Small and P.S. Jones.
Yeah, P.S. Jones and John Small. I went out there not long ago, and I just walked right in the front door and walked anywhere I wanted to. I could have had a gun just as easily as not.
That's the way they all are.
Yeah.
They were built for openness.
And Eastern Elementary, that one would be very easy to do because you got to come in that front door, and they just put two partitions so you can't get to none of the classrooms.
Let me ask you a question, Ron.
I
don't have a problem with what you propose. Yeah. Is this now when you say positions, that's reoccurring money. Are you talking about a one-time thing, or you just want to put it out there for the positions?
Put it out there.
Okay.
They need additional capital.
I got you.
And on the safety and security they're talking about, I'm looking at their plan here. Bath, Chuckawinity Middle, Chuckawinity Primary, Eastern Elementary, Taylor, Northeast, P.S. Jones, Snowden, Southside, Washington High. So... You know, they're beginning to plan for providing security and safety for the children of the county.
What I was asking you, I understand the security and safety part. I was talking about personnel.
Yeah, that would be a recurring. That would allow them to maintain at least half of the teachers they'd have to lay off with the recommended budget.
I got you.
Or the positions, I should say. And it gets back to some of the things that Rob was talking about with the COLA. So it's we're giving a COLA, we're helping the school system out somewhat with some of their positions.
I just wonder where all this money's coming from.
That's up to the county manager.
If you appropriate $3.25 million.
Ryan, yes. Ryan, do you just about lost my track here? their enrollment has dropped 125. I'm assuming, or these positions, do they include the loss because of student enrollment?
They, in the budget they proposed to us, they took into consideration the ADM cut and the salary increase.
Okay, so they're...
That was up front. They took that into consideration. And in that budget, they were proposing losing positions. Now, it may not be people, but positions. I don't recall the number of actual bodies. I think it was 23 TAs and about 13 teachers. In the recommended budget, so that's what they proposed to us. In the recommended budget by the county manager, there was an additional 10 to 15 positions, which could be live bodies,
that they were estimating that they would lose. So I'm coming back and saying, well, geez, let's help them out with at least six of those positions. And maybe the others could be through attrition. That's what I'm saying.
So what's the bottom line on it?
Bottom line is 466, 920, 325.
$466,000.
That's for capital.
That's for capital, 920. And that's the beginning of a five-year plan, and then $325,000 for current expenses.
And the comment on the security, safety and security, is that, you know, we were told that that would be a five-year plan.
Correct.
But they also have a plan to try to do the ones that I would say more at risk the first year.
Yes, yes, definitely, yes. When you look at the proposal that they provided, it's broken down that way. So there's stuff that they... And they're leaving until the second year, the third, through 2 to 5 years. Correct.
Okay.
Put your numbers out again.
You want to do these things separately, or are you going to lump them together?
466. Well, he's 325.
He's saying you want to do these items separately, or you just put them together for a total?
Together.
Put them together. And so the total dollar amount we're talking about is what, 800?
Right at it.
I'll tell you in a second. 791 920. 800. We hadn't gotten to Robert's cuts yet, so 791 920.
If you're gonna spend all this money, it didn't do any good to cut. You might as well keep everything in there.
Chairman, just deplete the fund balance. 791 920.
Okay. Any other discussion concerning these items?
Mr. Chairman, as much as I love the schools, I can't vote for that. It's just, I mean,
I understand.
It's a steer budget year.
I'm same way.
And I love the schools. I've been a part of them for 40 years, and I was on the school board, and even I can't vote for this.
Okay, it's not a problem.
And I'm the same way. I think the school system is very, very important, especially to our kids and
excuse me,
a lot of people. But you know, that's just we're just spending way too much money.
Okay.
Could I ask a question?
Yes, sir.
Would you consider, and all of us just say a gracious prayer that don't let out those schools and do anything crazy, would you consider saving the positions and we look at the capital later?
I would find that difficult.
Okay.
I would find that extremely difficult.
Okay.
The times we live in, it's changing.
I got you.
And I'm concerned. I'm concerned for those students and those teachers.
I got you. I don't have no question.
Okay. All right.
Let's break them down. Let's not do it as two.
Okay. I don't have a problem with that.
I'll go along with that.
So the first one is personnel, and that's the 325, whatever.
325.
Yeah. Well, Mr. Chairman, traditionally, until this year, I go back a lot of budgets with the schools. Traditionally, until this year, and Brian presented as an austere budget, the increase for the schools in the current expense, which is where these personnel would come from, it's traditionally been about $500,000 a year. To give them $500,000 every year. Last year we gave them $560,000, an extra $60,000 to do the $100 addition to the supplement. So this 325 is not out of line with what we've done in the past. The problem we've got is that we just probably don't have the money we've had in the past. And I mean, I'd love to give them $500,000, but you know, the way it is, $325,000 to save the positions. I don't. If we can afford it, I'd do it. But I don't know if we can afford it.
Okay. All right. Now concerning the $325,000, all in favor of that particular one, raise your hand. Okay. Five. Now, concerning the security, which is, was it 466, 299?
466.9.
466 what?
920.
920, okay, I had it wrong. Any other discussion before we vote? All in favor of that one, raise your hand. That one's against? Against?
Oh.
Against, two?
Yes, against.
Okay, you didn't raise your hand. 4-2.
Yep.
I pray that we don't have any more.
Mr. Chair, I just got one question for you. On that funding, because you have to allocate current expense and capital, my assumption, and I want to clarify that with you, is that what you'll do, because when we presented it, we said allow some flexibility in that spending, in how you allocated that money. Do you want us to go back and give them what we proposed, which was prior year? So that would be $1.5 million in capital plus the $466,920 as their capital money, and then take what they got last year, $13,233,163, and add the $325,000 to it for their current. Is that okay? Just want to clarify.
Let me ask the question.
Let me make sure I understand it. Right. My vote was taking your recommended budget and stacking on top of these two numbers.
Yes, and my recommended budget didn't specifically allocate capital and current expense, because I was going to allow, we talked about allowing some flexibility for the schools to say, let's flex on that a little bit. But what we now need to know is, we got to drill it down so we can say this is capital, this is current expense.
Let me ask this.
And so we're going to take your original recommendation, stack these two numbers, and then you're going to pull out the 466 and show that as capital?
No, sir. What I was planning on doing was, if you look back, if you go to page 117. Okay.
What page?
117.
Okay.
You'll see that the original 15-16 current expense budget is $13,233,163. And then the capital outlay budget current year was 1.8. There was the $300,000 additional. So what we recommended was $13,233,163 in current and $1.5 million in capital. But we didn't separate them out. We combined them together and said at the very bottom, that's the total, to allow for some flexibility for the schools to decide to say, you know, we may want to do less capital, let's do this. But so now what we need to do is drill down and decide what that's going to be. So what I was asking was, if you took the $13,233,163 and then added this additional continuing expense, $325,000 to it, that's where your current expense would be. And then you would take the $1.5 million and add the $466,920 to it, and that would be their current expense capital allocation.
Well,
my question is, if we're going to change that back and give them $1.5 million in capital, then they should be responsible some of this $466,000 out of their capital, because we don't know how they would have done this thing. But we're increasing the capital over what they got last year by $466,000, which was the normal appropriation to capital. I think what we should do is if you're going to give them the $325,000 in current expense, make them pay the $466,000 out of the $1.5 we give them in capital. That still leaves them $1,034,000 to spend on capital for the year. That's not going to be bad, because, you know, if you remember just a few years ago, all you were giving them in capital was $1 million.
I was confused when I voted the first time. I forgot there was 1.5. I mean, it was roughly 1.5 in there for capital. I'm sort of like Robert. I feel like that they can, that's their decision, you know, to take the.
If they don't do it, Ron's going to be real disappointed, I think. But that's, you know, you're giving them the money, you got to take your chances, I reckon.
Okay, what are we cutting out then on the capital request that they had?
$466,000.
Well, we don't cut anything. They cut it, Ron.
No, when you look at what they requested.
Yeah, but see, we don't cut anything. We just give them an amount, and then they use the capital the way they see fit.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is, correct me if I'm wrong, is they presented a budget to us. We cut that budget further in capital and in expenses.
Sure.
Right?
Always gets done every
I know year. That. But we cut, so what do we, if we take the 4.6 and say you're responsible for it, where are we cutting, what else are we cutting out of their budget then? Because we're cutting that $460,000 in additional funding.
Whatever they choose to cut out of.
Yeah, but what's the impact?
Give them $1,034,000, they can spend it. We've given them permission since we voted that they didn't have to come up here and explain to us what they were doing. They'll come up here and give us a one-time thing of $1,034,000. How are they going to spend it? And then, you know, they don't have to come back like they used to. They just go spend it the way they say they're going to do. And when they get to $1,034,000,
They stop.
Yeah. What I'm saying is the safety and security was over and above what we were giving them in the recommended budget, the way I look at these numbers.
All right, well, see, we just look at it two different ways then. That's all.
Well.
So, you got a motion? I mean, was that a motion?
I just said that I don't think if we give them $1.5 million in capital and $325,000 increase in current expense, that the $466,000 can come out of the $1.5 million if that's how they choose to do it. Okay. If they choose to do no security and spend it a different way, they are a duly elected board. That's what they can do. And they just don't put as high a priority on security as Ron does.
Is that what you were thinking, Commissioner Waters? Well, let me see if I can answer Ron's question. If you take the current expense in 15 and 16 and you add $800,000 to it, which was kind of the hit that they were expecting on personnel because of the state, that gets you up to say $1.4 million. If you add the 325 to that 14,733,000, that gets you to 15. So basically that gives them the option of mixing. If you just give them the 325 and raise that bottom figure up, they can play around. It'll either be $1 million in capital or $1.5 million in capital, and they've got the other money really to play around with as it comes to current expense, which is, I think what Robert is saying is we give them the lump sum and it's her decision to decide what they're going to do with it.
But I think Brian was asking us a minute ago. What he was asking you a minute ago is you don't give them any longer the option of playing with that $1.5 million. That $1.5 million is in capital because that's the question Brian was asking you. Do you want the whole $1.5 million to be in capital and give them the $325 in current expense? The $325 in current expense would be added to the $13,233. Putting them up a little over 13.5, you see, and then Brian is saying that $1.5 million is designated money to capital. I'm saying that we would encourage the school board to take $466,000 of that and do security upgrades with it out of that $1.5 million. But if they choose not to do that, Ron thinks that should be security in the schools. And we're giving them that money. But if they choose not to take that $466,000 and use it on security, they don't do it. They choose it for these other projects that they've got listed down
there. Let me pick up on something Bob said. We did the same thing last year on several projects and did as far as giving them the money, letting them spend it the way they wanted to. But we told them that here's money, we want to see this project done or that project done, and they pretty much did exactly what we asked them to do.
I think if they
think that security is that high on the board, then they'll take the $400,000 and spend it that way. Yeah. I believe they will anyway.
I hear a lot of numbers being thrown around. What I need to know is, what did they request in capital? Okay. What did they request in funds? What we recommended, and then, because I don't think they have the 466 in the recommended budget.
Okay, everybody get your pencils ready. All right, so what they requested in capital, let's go with capital first. Mm-hmm.
They requested in their budget $1,837,643. That's off this big sheet that they gave y'all in the joint meeting. Now, if you look at the top, that includes, that capital request includes $466,920 for security and safety. That's the very top line. Add it all down, it comes to 1.833. So okay, that one is included in that. So they asked for all of that in their $1.8 million request for capital.
Correct.
What you're saying right now is if you do the 1.5 and the 480, you're at 1.9. You're above what they actually asked for.
You don't want to do that.
That's what you were. That's what you're saying. Over there.
So bring them back to the 1.9. Bring them back to the. The number I'm looking here is 1.958. Is that the number?
1.837643.
Okay. Bring them back to that number.
Okay.
How much would that be out of the 466,920?
It's in there.
Right. It is in there.
Oh, okay. It's no, but there. I mean, what we recommend 1.5.
1.5 plus 466.
Okay, so if we recommend 1.5.
6.
What we're giving them is 337,920 then, correct? No.
If you recommend 1.5, they're 337 less than what they requested.
That's right.
But you can always find cuts in the budget. They don't have to have 1.837 in order to do that.
We've already cut them. We've cut them for what they asked to 1.5.
Right, and they're going to do just like we're going to do later. We're going to cut this budget.
I mean, you cut them. If I'm looking at these numbers right, they requested 1.837 and change, and we cut them to 1.5, so we cut them $337,000. And what you're asking them is to cut more out of the 1.5.
No, I'm asking them. I'm not asking them to cut any more out of that. I'm asking them to pay for the security system out of that 1.5.
I can live with, and I'm only one person. I can live with.
Give us a number on the current expense.
Current expense, they requested $14,300,984.
Do that again.
$14,300,984.
And with the 325 we're recommending?
With the 325 you're recommending, if we use last year's number, 13,558,163. That would be the total.
13,558,163. That's your new total on current expense.
Yes, sir.
The 325.
Yes, sir.
But see, Ron, we're still almost $800,000 under what they asked for in current expense.
But I need to have the numbers in front of me.
Okay.
So give me the numbers again.
Okay. What they asked for this year in current expense, $14,300,984.
Okay.
What we recommended was $13,233,163. If you add in the current expense of $325 that you talked about, that new number would be $13,558,163.
Okay, so they asked for 14 million. You recommended 13 million, correct?
13,233, which is what they got last year.
Okay. So that's only a difference between what they requested and what you recommend. It was about $60,000+, correct?
That's a $1 million difference, Ron.
$1,067,821.
Okay.
They asked for 14.3. We gave them 13.3, and now you've bumped it by $325.
So what I was recommending is to that figure, we add the 325, and to the capital we add 337. Then, since they only requested 1.8, and we're getting 1.5. That lowers the numbers.
And pass that down, Ron.
Okay, if you do that, then your operating number would be still 13,558,163, and your new capital number would be 1837643, bringing them to the requested number.
Yeah, on capital. And then we'd be adding the 325 to the 13233, correct?
Which brings you to 13558.
Okay, so the number is lower.
Oh, it's not lower.
I said it's lower.
No. You were giving them more than they were asking for, Ron, when you added that 466 to the one. You were asking to give them 1.966. They only asked for 1837. Shoot, they were going to
lower number.
They were going to have a windfall.
All right, what y'all going to do?
So, on capital, it's 337643. Am I correct now with my numbers here? Since I can't find my
calculator.
Yes,
to bring them up to the request, that's what it would be.
And 325 for the expenses.
Correct.
It's still $700,000 less than we're...
I can tell you that.
Yeah, than they requested.
Well, while you're doing that, let me give you my math.
Do it, Frank.
I'll do two maths at one time.
My math is that if you look at what you recommended, which was $14,733,000, If I had the right number down, what they requested on the current and the capital came to $15,395,000.
Now, what they asked for in 16-17 current and capital was $16,138,627.
$16,138,627. Okay.
And that's made up of current expense $14,300,984.
Do it again.
14,300,984. And capital of the 1837643.
Gotcha.
So the difference, Commissioner Buzzio, is $613,544 between what they requested and your proposal.
Yeah, so I'm proposing now. You add them both up together, 337
and 7.
643 plus 325 comes to 662,000.
I got 613,544.
Okay, so give or take, I was rounding off, rounding up. In lieu of what I originally was requesting, was 711,9, about 719. So it's down almost $100,000.
Listen to this, Ron.
Go ahead. As long as I can write it down.
They requested $16,138,000.
Yep.
And the manager's recommended was $14,733,000.
Uh-huh.
So that's a cut of $1.4 million.
Yep.
And you're trying to give them back
$662,643 now.
You better check it again.
That was his new number.
466 and a 325. That's what I'm adding together.
Yeah. Yeah. But what I'm saying now, that would give more than they requested. So I lowered the 466,920, correct me if I'm wrong here, to 337,643.
You're right.
And that gives them what they were asking for and allows them to start the first year of the safety program. And then on the expenses, it's 325, and if you add those two numbers up, what'd you say, 619?
613,
which is about $100,000 less.
So I can put it in my spreadsheet. That 466 now is 337,643. 643. Thank you, Anita.
You're welcome.
And what that does is fully fund their capital request, mm-hmm, of 1.837643.
So I save $100,000.
I'm happy.
We vote on any of this yet, Mr. Chairman?
We did, but we're going to have to go back.
Yeah, let's, I was going
to. Now, as far as the current, you don't have to change it. We don't have to vote again about that current. What we have to vote again about is the capital.
Well, what we got from you on current was providing an additional $325,000 in current expense.
So that's not the number we're dealing with. We're dealing with the
capital.
The capital.
Right. And just for the record, so that would take the $13,233,163 plus the $325,000, which would give you a total now of current expense money of $13,558,163.
I got a question.
And for Frankie, I'm sorry, excuse me, Commissioner Waters, so the difference from what they requested. They requested $14,300,984.
Right.
And your capital that you're fixing to vote on would be $1,837,643, which is $337,643 more than you recommended in the budget.
That's correct.
$337,643 that you recommended in the budget, and $37,643 more than last year's appropriation, which included a $300,000 one-time appropriation.
Okay. Now, concerning the $337,643, all in favor, raise your right hand. It's a wash.
No. It's a wash.
It doesn't get approved. It goes back to the manager's 1.5 million.
Now,
well, wait a minute. You actually had a, and I'm not the parliamentarian, so be careful with me, but you voted originally 4-2 to provide $466,920 to the school system. So now you made a second motion that was to 337. That failed, so your standing motion or your standing order is 466,920.
But wasn't that 466 to come out of the 1.5?
No, that was in addition to.
It was an additional 466,920.
You got to vote again if you want to feel it.
Yeah.
I make a motion that we appropriate $1.5 million that the manager recommended in his budget to the school system for capital outlay.
But I think.
Can we do that tonight?
You cannot.
Okay, because I voted against it.
That's right.
And Robert, all of a sudden, Robert rules, not Robert Belcher.
And Mr. Chairman, Robert, I'm so, you know, is the safety and the security is a very important issue for me. I'm not going to make that motion.
Well, it was the motion.
Well, whatever, for a straw vote.
I'll accept
the 337, but it didn't pass. So it's 469.
All right, so wait, the standing increase is the 466. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
But you got to vote on again.
Yes.
In order to change, you have to vote again.
What was the vote on the last one, Katie? Who voted up to which one?
3-3. Well, I'm the one who can pull it back up.
Oh, okay.
And I'm just being moot right now.
I was doing. I was trying to find out who was voting with me on that last.
Yeah, that's what it was. It was me.
Okay. Oh, it was okay. So you could have a motion and a second again, and without me a part of.
Is the 466? Did it go down for capital or just as an increase?
It went for capital.
For capital.
Yes, sir.
I got a question, Mr. Chairman.
Go ahead.
Mr. Belcher, in your previous presentation, you said that under their budget that they gave us, security was already included in it anyway.
$1,837,463 included the security, which was $466,000 for the Was the security 466?
Yeah.
I got you.
So that means that we would actually, if you took the security out, we would be actually appropriating them less money than the manager recommended. Subtract 466 from 837, you'd be less than $1.5 million, which is what he recommended.
466.
Yeah, but the vote was to expand it 466.
Yeah, that's right. But I said using hypotheticals is what I was using. If you took the 466 out, what we were actually appropriating to capital outlay.
Miss Anita.
I was talking with the manager to throw a monkey wrench into things.
Please don't. Further.
When we gave you that $1.8 million capital number off of their schedule, that did not include any of the modular replacements.
I know that.
That was separate.
Yeah. And I'm concerned about that, but being tight, my number one concern was the security and safety, and I wanted to make sure we had sufficient funds for that. And I'd like to fight for that, but 70 people on the board.
Okay. All right.
But let me say one more thing. You can be assured that their expenses in the school system have increased since last year, and that whole $325,000 will not go to teacher or teacher assistant salaries, because they're going to have some built-in costs that have gone up. So just remember that. Don't think that all of that's going to be able to go. That superintendent's going to go back and look at what inflation has done to them since last fall, and he's going to kick that out of that figure first.
And
generally, inflation will account in a school system current expense budget, it'll come in at about $200,000.
Well, I think given the public hearing is June the 6th, we have enough time to find out from the superintendent exactly what he intends to do.
Yeah.
And then we can act accordingly. If they're not going to do what our desires are, there's no need of giving them the money. That's just my opinion. I don't know how anybody else feels about that, but that's just the way I see it.
Well, they'll have a board meeting before we have ours, right?
They meet twice a month.
Yeah, but when is their next board meeting?
Do you have any?
Well, anyway, if Brian, if you can find out the answer to that question for us, I would greatly appreciate it.
Repeat the question.
That is the current of 325.
Yes, sir.
If in fact,
take a recess and call them now.
You have a number for them?
I do. I have a cell number.
Okay, we'll take a.
They're at a meeting in Northeast School.
Oh, they're meeting right now? Okay.
It ought to be over now.
Call a special meeting. I mean, that's, it's their budget.
But if you called them, if you get him, you'd have everybody together. But, look.
All right, we're going to recess.
I had to write the numbers down to get it straight.
All right, we're back from our break. Mr. Manager, I believe that you talked with the superintendent since we...
I did, yes. I had an opportunity to talk with Dr. Phipps, and so I have that information for you. So let's start where you stand right now with what you've currently approved. You've currently approved $325,000 additional dollars in operating. You've currently approved $337,646 in capital. Total of $662,643. Okay, the superintendent says that his operating budget, which is what they submitted, what they asked for, $14,300,984. He needs to get to that point. They've already made cuts. They discussed those cuts with you. But if he doesn't get to that point, he's going to have to make additional cuts. So what he would request that if you stick with where you are, if you take that 662,643 and reallocate it amongst capital and current operating so that he gets his full $14,300,984 in current expense. That means he won't have to cut anybody else. Then that would mean the capital costs would only be $1,094,822. And he said that their top priority out of that $1 million would be to do the security at 466.
That was
$1,094,822.
And that's with us giving them an increase of $662,643.
That would get him to the 14,300.
Now, and I apologize, we actually did that number wrong. The capital, let me back up. The 337,642 was on the last motion that you just made. Mm-hmm. That actually failed because it was 3.3. So there would actually be, yeah. So you actually had more money than that. But what he's saying is, if you got him to his operating at 14,300,984, then he would not have to cut any more positions. He'd be able to sustain. And that they could get by with the $1,094,822.
And that would allow them to do the security and safety.
Security piece was 466. They would make that the top priority out of that $1 million.
So that means, and see, I've been on that school board, I understand how this works. That means that, and listen to this, Ron. He's telling you that they asked you for, what was it, 1 million, what, in
1.8.
And he's telling you that he can live with 1.1 on capital outlay. So, and that current expense is more important. And if you give him capital outlay of 1.1, he'll spend $466,000 of that on a security. And he'll leave himself a little over $500,000 for every other capital outlay project they got this year.
Exactly right.
Well, that's what you said to start with it.
Well, I didn't know he would be willing to cut it that much. I thought he'd be willing to cut it back to 1.5. I never dreamed he'd go to 1.1 on it. He did that to get his current expense. I know what he's doing, but you got to understand, too, that once you give him that current expense, that's just like hiring a new position. That's a recurring cost. They gonna start next year at 14 what?
14,300,984.
Mm-hmm. They gonna start at that next year in their current expense, and they gonna want a 1.5 million capital in addition to that. So just remember, current expense, every time you hire a teacher, you put that cost in there forever.
Mr. Chairman, can I ask the county manager a question? So $14,300,984 is what they have to get to.
That's what he says he needs to.
Okay, how much?
The question was, would he have to cut any more positions? And he said, if he got to $14,300,984, he would not have to cut any additional positions.
And he would take care of the safety and security issues.
And out of the $1,094,822, they would make security top priority in that and spend that.
And to get the $14,300,984, how much in additional funds would we have to give?
Well, that's from what? It is an additional $1 million, $900,000 from your current expense.
It's 466 plus 325, isn't it?
Yeah.
Brian?
It's 325 plus 337, 643.
337.
Was the last number y'all used.
That was the last number you.
Yeah. All right, so we have to get, he's looking for $662,000 from us.
He's looking for every penny you can give him.
I know that. I'm asking you.
He's willing to take that.
He's willing to take 662. And what we've so far in our straw vote, we have approved. Not approved, but straw vote. 791,000. Am I right on that number?
Yes, sir. You have.
Yeah. So it means bringing it down by $130,000.
Yes.
Ron, take a look at all of those capital projects that they listed.
Then I would want to have...
Every one of them. Wait a minute, I'm talking.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Take a look at every one of those capital projects that he listed other than security that he said he needed to do this year, and he's got $590,000 to do them all. That's all he's got. Because he cut his capital back to just about nothing.
I did ask him about the modular units. He said those were already off the table.
They took them off the table. So they're going to leave the roped-off areas?
I don't know, but he said they were already off the table.
He had $1,837,000 worth of capital projects, which included the 466 for security. So if you take the 466 for security out, you're down to about 1.4 is what he said that he needed to do his capital projects for this coming year. What he's actually done is gone to $500,000 to do all of his capital projects for the year. Now he's going to have to pick and choose among his capital projects at about $550,000 to $75,000, which is going to be a mighty lean year in capital, and there not much going to get fixed.
Let me ask this: if we, and Commissioner Buzzy, I'm asking you this question. Okay. The 325 that we said for current, mm-hmm. and then with that 446, would you be willing to half that 446?
And that would come out to 233,000?
Yes.
And plus the 325, Mr. Chairman?
Plus the 325.
I'd be willing to do that.
And so that would be a total of 558? I know what the number he's talking about, but I'm talking about the number of what we're proposing.
Okay.
Can you say that again, please?
325.
The 325, and then halving the
166. Oh, halving. I'm sorry. I thought you said if you hack that. I didn't hear you say half. I'm sorry.
I got candy in my mouth.
Divided by two. So
466, 920 divided by two.
233,460 plus 325. Is 558,460.
Correct.
I'd be willing to do that, Mr. Chairman.
And out of that 558,460, you want to get to 14,300,984 and then allocate.
Well, I think actually with that number, we're going to miss that mark by our
233,000.
And what I'm saying is, if we got him that close, they can find it. That's just my thoughts.
Yeah, wait. Let me ask a question. Originally you said 662, 643 would get him to his mark, right? That's what I heard. And we're suggesting, the chairman's suggesting, that we make it 558,460, which means we got him within $100,000 of his mark, if the numbers are right. Because I think you said originally to get him to his mark would be 662,643. And Cam is recommending that we cut the capital by half, and I think that number drops it down to 558, which is $100,000 less.
Current expense in the capital.
I'm just trying to figure out what you want to allocate amongst operating
capital.
Same amount next and basically what I'm doing is I'm giving you a number. And
which piece? Capital or operating?
What I'm saying is we're giving you the number, and you make it work where it works best.
For them, is what you're saying? Because
so that this board is satisfied with what they do.
Okay, may I?
Yes, please.
All right, if you go back and look at page 117 and look at the total that the manager recommended, the 14,733,163.
Mm-hmm.
I think had we just given them that, based on conversations, they would have wanted to take that whole total and put it to operating.
They wouldn't have done any capital.
For the 14.3, and then the difference between the 14.733 and the 14.3 would have been their capital balance.
Which would have been 433,000. That wouldn't even been enough to do the security.
So I think.
So what they are telling you is basically their priority is current expense. And the heck with the capital. They're just gonna Jerry, using your term, they're just gonna kick the can down the road on capital this year is what they say.
And that's not what I'm sorry, Robert. That's not what I've heard. I've heard the security and safety is an important issue of theirs, and it's a number one priority. And they need funding in order to take care of that.
Well, and I would agree with that. They've said that's a priority for them.
Yeah.
But if you don't give them all of that money, I think their priority with their limited resources is going to be current expense.
But I heard you earlier say that 662, 643 would give them the number they need.
Well,
based upon the conversation you had with them.
Well, what the conversation was, what have you got to have? What I said to them was, right now the board has talked about adding 325 to current expense, and at that time I said 466,920, mm-hmm. because that was your last approved vote to capital. And the 466,920 would have overfunded your capital request because you only asked for 1.8. This would have taken it to 1.9 or mm-hmm. something. So it would have overfunded your capital request. What do you think about that? And he said, I would rather you fund my operating at the 14.3 level so that I don't have to cut any more positions, and then I'll take what's left and put it in capital. And out of that, it would have been about $1 million. He said, and I will use that to do the security first.
Okay. But what I'm saying, what the chairman is recommending, is that we give him 558,460, which is $100,000 less than the conversation you had with the Am I right on that? Am I wrong?
Yeah.
So it's $100,000 less than he said he needs. Mm-hmm. And what the chairman, I believe, said, and I don't want to put words in his mouth, is that they have to find the other $100,000.
In which I think with a budget their size, they can find that. They can find that. I really and truly believe that. And you can.
Good. Mr. Chairman, if you take the manager's recommended number, which was 14,733,000, and you throw over there 567,000 on top of that, that takes you to 15,300,000, and they're asking for 14.3 in current. So that means they're going to spend $1 million on capital. So all we got to do is bump it 9 from what you guys just talked about when you have to, $9. And then we can tell them we want them to spend $1 million on capital and the 14.3 or a lesser number on current expense.
So what's your final number you want to, you would like to get?
Right now, if you added just $9 to that 233, if you add $9 to it, and then you add it to Brian's original budget, that's going to take us to 15,300,000.
I got 15,381.
And they want 14.3 in the current. So my question is that, you know, do we tell them $1 million or we tell them $1.2 million in capital? I think is that your point? I mean, or do we just try to get them there on the total and let them break it down?
Well, what I would do is give him his current expense request was $14,300,984. I'd take whatever you're going to give him and subtract that amount from it, and that's what he gets in capital. Because that's what he asked you for right there. He said he can do everything he wants to do with that number. What's your big number now? 15 what?
15,395,806.
Subtract 14,300,984 from it.
It's a little over $1 million.
$10,094,822.
That's his capital.
That's what we have.
And that's what he said would make him happy.
That's where we started when we came back after the break.
Now, Jerry said, now what Jerry said is take that 622, cut it in half, and knock some of that off of that figure, didn't you, Jerry?
No, not the 622. He said the 446.
446. Take the 446.
466.
Cut the 466. Cut that
in half.
Half that, mm-hmm. and subtract that from that $15 million figure.
And that is the number.
And make it work.
You're at what now?
All right, hold on. He's saying that's going to be the amount, the additional amount, not the 662, right?
Right, that's going to be the additional amount.
So 14,760. Okay, that's the total. Take that amount.
You didn't turn that back on, did you?
Yeah. It's hot in here.
It's because you got red hair.
It is. It's stuffy in here.
Where?
All right. So
that's all the heat coming off of this table.
Go slow on the numbers.
So if you take the original amount that we had recommended in the budget, right, and then you take the 325 for current expense, and then you take half of the 466,920, which is 322,460. 233,460, sorry. Add both of those together, that's 558,460. Okay. 60. That gets added into the total number that we recommended originally.
14,733,163.
So you get that total, which is 15,291,623, and you take off the 14,300,984, which fully funds their requested current expense. Then that leaves you a capital amount of $990,639.
That's exactly what I got.
Yay.
Now, where's the $1,094 he talked about?
That's coming out of the total.
That was originally where it was when you were using the total amount instead of cutting.
Okay, that's the 100,000.
That's the cutting the 466 in half. That was before you cut it in half.
Yeah. So he said he could live with the 14,300,000.
He did.
Well, that's exactly what he asked for.
Right.
14,300,000.
He essentially said, I'll take whatever I got to take out of capital to get me to 14.3 million.
What does that give him in capital? Nine what?
990,639.
And he's going to do secure. He said he's going to do safety with that.
He said safety is their top priority, and they would do that first as they could.
And how much fund balance did he say he had?
He did.
I don't remember.
He said
it was 800 some thousand.
Yeah, he said how much they had. I remember him.
It was close to nine.
Yeah, mm-hmm. That's what I remember. It was close to nine.
Yeah.
You know, he's spending it the way he wants to. I mean, we're giving him a bunch of money. He's spending it the way he feels is best. And like, if he got that 990, and he don't do the security, then he don't do it. He's still sitting there. Something else more.
And so now, I guess I'll make another motion for the straw vote is, and that is to make it the number of 558,460, which is a, it's not two separate motions, just one, 558,460. That's the expansion.
Five what?
558,460. Now, any discussion about that?
558,460?
558,460.
That's expansion. Mm-hmm. We're just going to do it as one number, is that?
One number.
Yeah, because that's where you want it.
All right. All in favor of that, raise your right hand. Okay. 5-1. Yeah, Gary. Is that it for the expansion? I believe so. Does anybody else, nobody has anything else, do they?
Be afraid to say it.
What's the, tell us the tally, if you're up with us.
I really want to know.
Yeah, I really want to know.
I'm already joking.
You. That's a lot of bucks.
You ready? It's 1,147,427.
And 1 cent.
100.
say it again, Brother Frank.
In the banking world, we would say $1,150,000.
Yeah.
No, but it's, but the actual number is $1,147,427.
Dead on.
$427.
$427.
The fun begins. Robert wants to start with the.
I don't want to start with anything. I want to. I want to go home.
No scared.
Front line. Well, I'll start.
Hey.
I got to start.
All right, let me get my budget out there.
Okay, in the this is after the budget was prepared. The EMS savings now is at $138,962.
Read it.
And in the sheriff's department, and I guess that's the sheriff's department, the jail, 911, all three of them, his cuts this last time when Charlie came in was $149,086. Yes. And I'm going to add to that the Beaufort County home demolition, $275,000. And I'd like to see us sell that for $10 and eliminate it altogether. No, just to put the $10 in there.
Was that an offer?
No. Just eliminate the, or defer it, I guess is that, for further study, $275,000. And you want me to throw another one out there?
Go for it.
Keep going.
I would throw a cut for the Beaufort County Community College on their capital. Because of the recent bond referendum, they're receiving $6.5 million, and I would like to see them use more of that money to do major renovation. If I understand it correctly, the repairs and renovation have a life expectancy of 10 years or more. The $2 million that they're planning, I'm not recommending cut it $2 million right now, but the $2 million that they're planning on spending on the building with the space we have at the college, I would really like to see them start spending $2 million in that project or over the next 3 or 4 years to do some of the renovation. And I'm recommending that we cut the capital budget $500,000. They're asking for I think last year it was $700,000 or $800,000 in capital.
Seven.
I think the increase you recommended in your budget was 640, wasn't it, for them overall?
The 640 is what they got last year. They asked this year for 723,000 in capital expense.
But wasn't your recommendation 640?
Right, which was prior year. So that,
I'm not opposed to the drive-in pad, but I think with the space we have out there, that a $2 million building is not a wise decision long-term. And that's, unless you want it, you guys have already said you don't want to cut the lobbyist.
What is that? What is that total, Frank?
That's $1,063,048. $1,063,048.
That's what I got.
I recommend cut the space needs study in the Talon building parking lot repair for a total of $83,000.
Repeat that, please, Robert.
The county facility space needs study, $50,000, and the Talon parking lot, $33,000.
Yours is $83,000?
Total.
Did you say the county jail?
No.
Need study?
Space needs studies. It's something Brian put in there. Tell him what it is, Brian.
It is a study that we were going to do on the existing facilities to understand what we needed to do with renovations and moving folks around and handling your facilities.
And that maintenance also, maintenance needs, or?
No. As far as it would go, but it was more of a space needs study to understand in this area and in the different facilities that we have.
$1,096,048. $1,196,048. How much was our increases over?
$1,477,427.
What was the total?
We need to find $300,000 more. How much? $300,000 more.
What's your total?
Yes.
And you need
a number? Your turn.
Yeah. Give us a number.
Right now, with that, the space needs study being cut at $50,000, Thailand parking lot repair at $33,000, EMS savings at $138,962, the sheriff's cuts at $149,086, the demolition of the county home at $275,000, and the capital at Burford Community College at $500,000. That total is $1,146,048.
I missed some somewhere.
So that's
that other total of on the expansion was $1,147,000. So you're pretty much there.
The difference is $1,379.
You're right.
So Robert, just write us a check and we can all go home.
$1,000.
Robert just told me that he was ready to go home. He would support the 2 cent tax increase.
I didn't say I was ready to go home that bad.
I think we can find you $1,379 in the budget.
Okay.
Yeah. How much? I was going to ask this question, and if it's okay, Mr. Chairman.
Yes, sir.
How much during the year, you know, you fully fund all positions for the 12 months. How much during the year will your vacancies usually give you to play with? Where people aren't in positions and you're actually saving those salaries.
Lapsed salaries.
I'm really too new to know. We can look at it and.
Well, I'm thinking, you know, that if we've got some leeway here, that's you'll have some play with that, won't you?
We will. There'll be some play.
Yeah, it can. I know when the schools, it could amount to a pretty tidy little sum of money if you didn't replace somebody for a while.
Well, and it just depends on where that position is, and you know, but there will be some. I mean, even if someone leaves and gives us 2 week notice, it takes a little bit longer, 2 weeks to get them get rehired. Even if we tried as fast as we could, so there will be a little bit of play in there.
Anita,
yes.
Can you give me the total amount of expansion?
It's $1,147,427.
And the cuts again was $1,046,000.
$1,146,048.
Brian, Mr. Chairman.
Yeah, go ahead.
Brian, the cutting out of the needs study, what's the impact of that?
We'll do it internally and do the best we can. Christine's still sitting over there. We'll engage our in-house professional engineer to.
She says thanks a lot. That's really what she needs.
Is that Hood?
And we may also engage our sitting professional engineer on the board to assist. We'll have two. That hey, have.
Not today.
Yeah, go ahead.
Do you have any more comments?
I would see the impact of that. What the
come to the podium so it'll pick you up.
If the needs study was done by an outside firm, that firm would come in and they would interview the different department heads, and they would, you know, and meet with me and maintenance staff regarding the facilities of the buildings, the size, the square footage, that type of thing. But the main benefit in my mind with doing it with an outside firm is that a third party would come in and would meet with the different departments and get more of an honest evaluation from the department heads, because it's not just department heads that are county employees, but for instance in the courthouse you have other elected officials, and so it would give a buffer between county staff making decisions and other elected officials and that type of thing. So the outside firm it would just provide a buffer between different agencies working together.
And how much was that?
80.
It was 50,000. The parking lot was 33. That's why I came up with the 83.
Well, I'll walk over there and tell you for 25,000. I will.
Are there any thoughts on that? I'll do it for 10.
And Frankie. Only thing I have with these cuts is I know this is, it's not a deal breaker, but we're still wrestling with some water to that firehouse out there at the community college. Now, I don't know whether they're going to get that money in time to do what they need to do.
I thought the city was going to do that.
Brian, I don't think that.
The city agreed to fund $25,000 in it if the county funded the remaining amount.
And the thing that bothers me is, yes, they're gonna get a wad of money. But during this legislative session, which we when I was working, we used to call it funny time. Ain't no telling when they get that money. The different ones now already getting their hands in it. I heard recently, is last week, they want to look at some of it for transportation. They want to go back, and I don't think that's gonna happen, guys. Because the people voted on the bond a certain way. But the thing that bothers me is we don't know when they're gonna get that money. I mean, we got a Speaker of the House and a President of the Senate and a Governor. That's all three of them they look like this board sometimes. And that's the only thing that bothers me.
They look worse than this board.
But that's the thing that bothers me is we don't know. I mean, we need to have some kind of safety net. In case, they're getting the money in draws. They're not getting all this at one time. And I appreciate the cuts that you made, the good cuts, but I just want to put that out there that's the part that bothers me. And if we can be standing on the sideline for them if they need us.
What's the dollar amount for that project that they're looking from the county to?
Total was about $5 million.
Hang on a second.
No, we're just talking about the water.
We're talking about water. We're talking about running water.
Oh, the water. Right? I thought you were talking about the parking pad and everything.
It's
parking pad and the classroom.
$3 million.
Yeah, and the
classroom. $25,000.
$25,000.
Water line for the burn house is listed in their minor capital project at $25,000. Yeah, my assumption is that is the request from the county. Because there was a 25, it was a match to the city's 25.
And it might not take that, is it?
It might not. I don't know.
But I mean, that's just something I want to throw out there. I mean, I'm pleased with what's been done. I just don't want to box ourselves in.
Mr. Chairman, should we ask the community college representative to? Well, we don't have another meeting, do we?
No. We'll have the public hearing is what's next, and that's at our regular scheduled meeting, which will be over in the courthouse.
And I didn't do that to change anything. I just put it out there as a buffer.
I think the board's responsibility is to make sure that if something happens out there, that it's our building, so we would make that repair. And we're not totally wiping out their capital. But I think that, you know, as they plan, they should have some indication from this board as it relates to their plans on the $6.5 million.
Well, like I said, this is not a deal breaker. I just wanted to put that out there in case we just don't want to have them shut down on that project.
Okay. Is there anything further for this evening?
Or how about the solid waste?
Yes, sir. You got the solid waste and the water fund as well.
Mr. Chairman, on the solid waste, we had some discussion about 142. I would either like to see us do the 140 or go to 145, and I don't particularly like the 142. I think 145 gives us a little extra money in there to maintain and make improvements in the sites. And if I heard you correctly, we own 11 sites. And with that sort of money, we probably would be able to make improvements on, I would think, maybe 3 to keep them.
You would be able to do a little more. And also, right. one of the conversations, and we had this conversation with the board 1 or 2 meetings ago regarding the recycling subsidy that you provide to help offset the cost of recycling, because it costs us a lot more for municipal solid waste tipping fee than it does the recycling tipping fee. So we want to try to keep as much out of that waste stream as we can. Currently, you're providing it at $20 a ton, and the request that came from the city was that you up that by $15 a ton. What that essentially would equate to is about $10,000 or $11,000 a year in the solid waste fund. You would have sufficient funds to do that at the amount you're talking about, as well as do 2 or 3, depending upon the severity of the convenience sites, 2 or 3 each year.
Going to 145 would generate another $66,000.
My figure is 110. Is it 22,000 households?
21.
30, you're right. 30. When you go from 140 to 145, I was looking at 145.
We were at 140, is that correct?
We were at 140.
And the board agreed at 142.
You did.
We said that would give us about $40,000 a year to redo those convenience sites.
That 140 was just a break in.
Break even.
With no money going to the enterprise fund or nothing like that. It was just.
That was pretty much break even.
But if you went from 140 to 145, it generates $110,000 for improvements at 11 sites.
Let's build a little fund balance in that fund, because that is a newly established fund starting out with a zero fund balance.
So my recommendation is we do 145.
Any other discussion?
Well, I'd like, if I may, I'd like to keep it at 142 for this year and then go to 145 the following year. That's just the way I feel about it. I think we've had, y'all are getting ready to pass a 2% increase or 2.5% increase, and now you're up in the solid waste by $5 a year, you know, and that's just an out of tax. So I can't vote for 45. I'd like for it to stay at 142.
So you're not voting for another $3? That's
correct.
Okay, so Frankie has a motion for the 145. So let's deal with the 145. All in favor of the 145, raise your hand. Opposed? Okay. 4-2.
And could we get a little bit of direction on the recycling offset that was recommended, that we bump that by $15 to 35, which would essentially cause us to add back into the continuation budget about $11,000?
That charge is to the city of Washington?
That charge is to offset their cost of recycling. See, right now, the way it works is you're paying for all solid waste disposal. The city, and in our recycling rate, we have a recycling rate. The city of Washington picks up municipal solid waste. You pay for the disposal, but for their recycling, they have to take that to, what is it, ECVC. They take it to ECVC, and that rate is jumped to $47 per ton. Mm-hmm. It was originally
28.
It was originally zero until October of last year. Then it went to 28, and then it went to 47 in February.
Right.
Mr. Chairman, what's happening here is that recycling is becoming more expensive because the people can't sell the recycled stuff because it's cheaper to make it new. A brand new plastic bottle is cheaper to make than to recycle the stuff and do the bottle. And that's why the cost of this stuff is going up. And I didn't understand it when I first started looking at it. I said, that's crazy. Here, recycles. But it's not, because the price of oil has come down so much that it just makes that more expensive to recycle than it does. And so they're having to go up on the recycling fees because they won't buy the recycling from you. What you're basically doing is sending the recycling to the dump now, isn't it?
No.
I mean, what? I mean, you almost got to. I mean, you. They. I don't know what they're doing with it once they get it, because they can't sell it.
They're carrying it to ECVC.
I mean, what's ECVC doing with it? They can't sell it for hardly can. Or is it just down to zero?
It runs on surcharges. They have a surcharge on it to take it. The price of oil goes up, the surcharge
comes down. Okay, I got you now. I see what you're saying.
If you would allow us to do that, I mean, I think your funding is enough for us to do that. It helps us help ensure that recycling continues and keeps stuff out of the municipal system.
I think $15 a ton.
It would be an increase from $20 a ton to $35 a ton. So it's an increase of $15 per ton. And on average, they were at 675 tons. So it's about $11,000 for $10,000 a year.
Okay. Mr. Boone. Didn't you say that our waste, I think Anita was telling us that these prices are locked in. Is it 3 or 5 years?
Ours are locked in for 5 years.
5 years.
Our tipping fees are locked in for 5 years.
Okay. But that our, what was Kelvin, BCDC, that fluctuates with the tonnage.
ECVC, the city deals with ECVC, and their prices do fluctuate based upon ECVC, based upon the demand for their materials.
So what my question is, we're safe, basically safe, for the next 5 years?
The county is, as far as their recycling costs.
We just had to deal with
our recycling costs are locked in for the next 5 years. Okay. Yes.
God, trash.
Big business.
It is a big business.
Dirty business.
Yes.
What are you voting on?
Don't have a motion.
I didn't think we could have a motion.
No, you're talking about your increase for that straw vote for the trash increase.
Yes. Yeah. Well, I guess one of us need to make the motion. I guess Frank has just made it. Is there a second?
Yeah, but what is the...
Are we upping it
to go from 20 to 35.
Oh, okay.
Yes, per ton.
That we ain't got no choice.
I second that, Mr. Chairman. We got no choice.
Yeah. Unless you set it in the backyard.
Either that or you going to bury it in the backyard.
I mean, I got
you. Makes for bad grass cutting.
You say we have no choice. What if we don't raise it $15 a ton?
Didn't the city of Washington have to pay all those costs?
It's not picking.
They're not going to do.
I mean.
And when you think about that, Washington is in Beaufort County.
And we pay to dispose of their solid waste. So if their recycling decreases and you get more municipal solid waste, then we would pay $76.72 per ton to dispose of additional solid waste.
That's why it's to our benefit to try to drive people to recycle.
Now I understand.
All right, all in favor, raise your hand. All right, it's unanimous. Was there anything else attached to solid waste?
No, sir.
The water fund, enterprise, water enterprise fund.
On the water, there was, you approved, you in
the upgrades.
Sorry?
The upgrades for Christina? Well,
actually, there was the, you've approved in the general fund by your straw poll the 2% COLA. There is a group of folks who work in the water fund who that did not include. So that's one of your service expansions for the water fund, and it is funded by the water fund.
Right, that's what I was about to say, but that's strictly. Mm-hmm. And also we talked about
rate increase.
The rate increases, as well as
the capital, the generators.
Generators. And
the model.
The model, as well as meters.
The meters are not included in.
In this.
In this as an expansion item in this budget.
Okay, no. Very good.
What our conversation about that was that we currently have there's $150,000 in the capital for the hydraulic model. We currently have a grant submission for the hydraulic model, and if you got that, then there would be some capital available to maybe look at.
Okay.
A meter replacement, starting a meter replacement program.
When we replace these meters, are we going to one of these meters that you can just go by and read?
We have not determined that yet. There are different types of AMR systems that are available. One would be a drive-by, which is what you're right. describing, which is what the city of Washington has. A second one is one which there are radio components that transmit, that we could put repeaters on our water towers and it would transmit immediately from the meter to the water tower and then back to a base station. There's also a third type of meter now that has been out for a couple of years, which is cellular based, and so that's part we're planning to do some type of trial study this coming budget year to analyze those different type of meters. The companies that manufacture these meters do radio studies to see if, based on our geography, what type of coverage we would get. We've completed that with the fixed base system, which is the one where the antennas would be on the water towers, and a cellular company is about to also do a study now. And so what we'll do is we'll look at the cost benefit analysis of those three different systems to determine which one. My gut feeling at the moment is we would not use a drive-by system. Drive-bys are generally more agreeable to more densely populated areas such as municipalities, where you have the grid system, where you have a lot of houses. The benefit to going to the AMR systems is to take trucks off of the road, so I would not be looking at a drive-by. I'm suspecting it will either be a fixed-base system or a cellular-based system based upon the radio studies.
And how many trucks would you take off the road?
I would not like to comment at that at this time until I get those studies in and I'm able to see that. But that is, I'll present a cost-benefit analysis that we'll have at that time, the number of vehicles and the savings that would be each year to help offset the cost of the meter system.
Commissioner Brent, just from that perspective, it is a great thing, and it does save money and save time, but it doesn't completely eliminate the human interface. There has to still be that.
Right. So. Absolutely.
Okay, so
that's what it looks like.
The expansion items are listed on page 347 of your budget.
What it was?
347. And again, keeping in mind that this is the enterprise fund, so all of these would be funded through the enterprise fund.
Correct.
And that's why we looked at the fund balance at the previous meeting.
All
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, sir.
I thought she was, the way I understood it when we left last time, Brian, correct me if I'm wrong on this, is that you had so much capital that you thought you could deal with that you had, and you were going to come back and make a recommendation to us on how many of those generators you could afford and still keep your water system solvent with your capital. Is that was not what you understood us to say the last time?
And that was the model that we showed you when we brought it back the other night, that if you did those at a 3% rate increase every other year, we felt like it would be okay in doing all of those projects, all those capital projects. But it would leave you about 22% fund balance at year 10. Now it doesn't eliminate, but it drastically curtails future out year capital projects. They would need to be addressed separately.
So you're looking at $600,000 for the generators total. Is that right?
First, that was $500,000 for the generators and $150,000 for the model. And again, cross our fingers, if we're lucky enough to get the model, then you could say we're not going to spend that $150,000, or you could use that $150,000, which we would come back to the board and address that.
But is
start a meter replacement.
Basically, the first year of the generator project will be $600,000, and that will do how many generators?
It would do the water on the south side of the river. It would do the treatment plant at the south side treatment plant, which is a large generator, and then also the generators for two of the wells on the south side, so that we're able to pump water from the wells to the treatment plant. And then it's also going, hopefully it will do the automatic transfer switch at the Washington treatment plant on the north side of the river. So we would do as much as we were able to do this year, and if I had, you know, $75,000 left over, then I could do additional electrical work at a pump station further down the road.
I guess what the question I'm asking is, with this $600,000, in the event of an outage, will you keep the water flowing on the south side of the river?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's one.
As well as the north?
No, sir.
To the residents on the south side?
Yes, sir.
And not the residents on the north side?
No, sir. Not in year one.
But
by the end of year two, then some of the residents on the north side, but not everyone at the same year. Yes, sir.
I know. It might be a silly question, but is there any such thing as getting these mobile generators?
Yes, sir. I would not recommend mobile generators at the water treatment plants because of the size of the generators and the unavailability of generators that size. And we did look at that, and probably what we will do is purchase, get the electrical, the infrastructure in place, because right now we do not have generator plugs. If you pull a generator up, you'd have to do the hard wiring to it. So we would do the electrical infrastructure first. But one of the downsizes of only getting portable generators is when you have road closures, hurricane, water across the roads, you still can't get to them, or even if you pre-stage and have the portable generators at the site, then you can't get the personnel to the generators to turn them on.
The reason for me asking that is it's going to be one terrible, terrible hurricane if the whole water system in the whole county is down.
Yes, sir. I agree with that 100%.
Terrible, terrible. So you're going to have generators sitting there for years and years and years that you never use. And if I'm correct, we had the problem on the south side. Didn't the Corps of Engineers or the Marines or something bring us in some generators or something to help
us? They did, but it was days before that occurred.
Well, the reason I was saying, if we had a mobile generator, I mean, you might need two. You might not need two, but
right.
It was just my thinking. And
for the booster pump stations, I agree with that, but large mobile generators, no, your water treatment plants need to have permanent generators there, in my opinion. And now you can't even get a treatment plant permitted without having emergency power as part of the plan.
I trust your opinion. But what I'm also thinking.
I understand.
What I'm also questioning. I mean, I'm not questioning where it needs to be, mm-hmm. by regulation.
Mm-hmm.
But But what I'm saying, if we got, what we got, 17, well, how many we need when we get the whole county covered in generators?
I have the
if we're done.
Plan. We probably would not, it would be at least the third year before we put smaller generators at every pump station, because they're not needed at every single pump station.
That's what I was meaning. Mm-hmm.
We're not doing every, like on the south side, for instance, there are multiple well houses, but we're only putting a generator at one well house. So if we're not, I'm not putting a generator at every single facility, because you just need to, you need to provide the power. We fill the tanks before a storm comes in. And then, but based upon the usage, different tanks drop at different levels. So we would put the first generator at the pump station that would fill the tank that has the largest usage. You know, down at the far end, Beach Ridge, even though it's a smaller tank, it can last a week and a half based upon its usage. The tank at Bunyan, at Douglas Crossroads, it feeds down Olive River Road. That tank drops. So it's a plan in place. Like I said, it's not going to be every single site. It's just the ones in order to keep the water in the tank.
I'm not sucker guessing mm-hmm. what you're saying. I'm mm-hmm. just trying to look at these dollars here, because the last time that we looked at, when there was grant fund, it was about $10 million in cost for generators, if I'm not mistaken, which we didn't get the grants a few years ago.
Yes, sir.
So that's what I was just looking at, mm-hmm. the mobile.
Mm-hmm.
I trust you.
Yep.
The one at Douglas Crossroads, will it last 24 hours or 48 hours if it's full before storm?
It depends on the usage, but it would last 24 hours. Okay. But that's a tank that we fill frequently.
But if you had a rupture.
If there's a major, and you can't, it's like insurance. You know, you insure what you can afford to insure, and we plan and we pre-plan and we plan again. But if it's something like what happened on the south side of the river, when houses were literally ripped off of their foundations and the service lines were just flapping in the wind, I mean, that's a catastrophic event, and we hope and pray that doesn't happen. So, but you know, even it's not just hurricanes, ice storms. If we have a severe ice storm and we lose power, you know, I worry about that as much as I do hurricanes. Because then again, you're talking back to the travel, and if you have ice storms, that means that your roads are impassable. So you can't be pulling a portable generator down a road with the 4 inches of ice on it. So,
is the staff recommending that we still have the 150 in there for the hydraulic model, or to go ahead and switch that?
Yeah, I think our recommendation would be that you leave it in there and hope that we get the grant. Because if you don't get the grant, that hydraulic model is a critical piece of our system to be able to understand the system and know what the pressures are doing and how we can.
Mr. Chairman, I recommend that we approve the expansion budget and pull that down from the reserve, capital reserve fund in the water.
Okay.
A second.
Have a motion and a second. Any further discussion?
I do need to ask you one question. When you say you're talking about just that one, right? You're not talking about the whole page.
Yes, he's talking about the whole page. Yes.
Okay, well, I do have to say one thing. The employee assistance program that's listed under human resources, you didn't fund that in the general fund, so
okay,
it wouldn't be appropriate to fund it for only the 27 folks who work in the water fund.
I would amend that.
Okay.
Unless you want to go back and put it in the general fund and fund it for everybody.
I'm okay.
All right, we have a motion and a second. All in favor, raise your hand. All right, it's unanimous. And that is it, isn't it?
I have a question.
Okay.
The employee assistance program, refresh my memory, how much would it cost in the general fund?
Hang on, let me get better.
It was like $7,000.
It was $6,607 in the general fund, and then $504 in the water fund, or about $7,000. Like
about $7,000. you know, it's to me, it's something we should consider. We do have a number of employees, and it's from previous experience, they're usually very effective programs.
Mr. Chairman, I make the motion we do the employee assistance fund and take it out of lapped salaries during the year, the money to fund it, you'll get $7,000 on a lap salary during the year, won't you, Brian?
I think we can find $7,000, yes, sir.
All right.
Okay. I second that. All in favor of that, raise your right hand. Opposed? It's unanimous.
Can I ask? Can I ask?
Please don't.
All right. I want some clarification on corporate community college, but I'll wait till a different time.
Can I ask Ron a question?
Have you got to?
Yeah. I had some questions on the public community college clarification.
Since you're going to have water on the side. We let all of us go over there and spend the night with you.
I won't charge much.
All right, we need a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
All in favor?
Out of here.